Morning students, today I am going to explain about structure of ovule. In last video I had explained you structure of anther, right? So and male gametobite. Now I am going to explain about structure of ovule. Okay, introduction. The female reproductive part of the plant is called gynoecium. The female reproductive part of the plant is called gynoecium. The word gynoecium, which is represents the pistils. Pistils. What is called pistils? Pistils means it is a female reproductive part. From that only the female reproductive parts of the style, stigma, ovary getting developed. Just getting developed from the pistils. So the pistil is also known as gynoecium. The meaning of the pistil and gynoecium is called female reproductive part. And the pistil which is derived from the carpel. So I told you the pistil and gynoecium is female reproductive part, other name. Okay. This pistil consisting of the style, stigma, ovule, ovary, everything is there. But the pistil which is derived from the carpel. What is carpel? Yes. Carpel meaning arises a small papillate outgrowth of meristematic tissue of floral primordium. If you see this diagram, in this second diagram, in this is a pedicel. You know that what is pedicel? Pedicel is a stalk which is connecting the flower, is called the pedicel. In the pedicel, you will be having the layer by layer or the hole by hole. So in the first layer is you will be having sepals. Sepals means calyx. Calyx is a first layer of the flower. And second one is petal. So that is the calyx is the last layer. And before the last layer is that is petals. So next to that is androecium, that is male part of the plant. And gynoecium is the last part. It is not a last part. This is the very first part which is arising from the flower. Where it is arises? I told you here it is arises from the carpel. So the carpel which is arising from the small papillate outgrowth, that is a small papillate outgrowth of tip of the floral primordium, that is tip of the meristematic tissue of floral primordium. Small papillate outgrowth of meristematic tissue of floral primordium. Floral primordium means that is group of cells which is going to give rise the flower. So in future it is going to give the flower by a group of cells is called the floral primordium. That group of cells we can also call it as the tissue. Okay, so that tissue is called meristematic tissue. On the tip of this tissue, there is a small papillate growth is there. Small papillate growth is there. Small outgrowth is there. So from that growth only we are getting a carpel. From the carpel only we are getting the ovary style stigma. Inside this ovary, you are getting a ovules. Inside the ovule, you will be getting the female gametopite. Okay. Did you understand this line? That is gynoecium, also called carpel. The carpel is arises from the small papillate outgrowth of meristematic tissue of the floral primordium. Number of ovules in there. If you see on flower, the flower consisting of, in some plants will be having one ovule. Examples, paddy, wheat and mango. And many ovules, that is papaya, watermelon, orchids, these kind of fruits having many ovules. So based on the ovules, the fruit seed will be there. Okay, that's the point of the last point of the introduction. So it is a female reproductive part, gynoecium. The word gynoecium represents one or more pistils. Pistils also called pistils, which is derived from the carpel. Carpel meaning a small papillate outgrowth of meristematic tissue of the floral primordium. A number of the ovule present in the ovary, if it is a one ovule, that is example paddy and wheat. If it is a many ovules, that is papaya, watermelon and orchids. So this diagram I had explained you, that is this is a last layer, that is first layer is our gynoecium layer. Gynoecium layer is consisting of the ovary style and stigma. Inside the ovary you will be having a placenta with a ovule, and this is pedicel, and this is a sepals is called producing a calyx, petals producing the corolla, and receptacle means all the union of the all layer is called receptacle. And anther and filamented united is called the stamen. Next. So next to the introduction, I am going to explain about structure of the ovule. So if you see the ovule, this is the structure of the ovule. So ovule is the female reproductive part. It is one of the reproductive, female reproductive part. This is your textbook diagram. So if you see the from the outer to inner, the first layer, that is always the ovule, is covered by the yellow color layer. That is, don't write the color in the exams. I am telling you for the understanding purpose. So this yellow color, that is, this layer is integumental layer. That is the ovule which is covered by the, or protected by the integument. This integument layer, that is called integuments, which is covering the ovule, is called the integumental layer. If you taking a mature ovule, that should consisting of one stack and body. So the mature ovule, if you are taking, that should consisting of the stack and ovary. So there is an one hanging part which is coming from the base of the ovule, is called the stack. The stack name is funicles or the funicle. This name is funicle or funiculus. Funicle or the funiculus. Suppose you are cutting the ovary, you can see the some red color things, that is called ovule. That particular ovule only they are showing here. This is diagrammatic representation of ovule. This is microscopic representation or microscopic observation of the ovule. They are given in your textbook. So here, that is the ovule which is covered by the integument layer. Next to the integument layer, if you taking a mature ovule, that should consist of one body along with the connecting stalk. So the stalk name is funicle or the funiculus. Its name is funicle or the funiculus. Okay, so where is this funicle is attached? This funicle is attached to the base of the ovule. This is anterior or the top of the ovule. This is base of the ovule. If you see the inverted ovule, the base of the ovule, the funicle is attached, and one end of the funicle is attached at the base of the ovule, and another end is, it is going to attach the ovule with the placenta. I already told you, this is your ovary. So this swelling part is called ovary. This elongated part is called style. This last end portion of the gynoecium is called stigma. What is the role of stigma? From the stigma only, our pollen grains are coming and depositing. So the stigma is act as the platform for the to observe, or platform for landing of the pollen grains. And this elongated, slender elongated part of the style is called, it is just bringing the pollen from the stigma to the ovary. If you see the inside of the ovary, there is a ovule will be there. The ovule in the ovary, which is connected by the placenta only. So the ovule in the ovary, which is connected by the placenta. And along with that, you will be having an elongated slender part to style. And then stigma. So this is a just landing platform of stigma. And this is the style. And this is ovary. Ovary consists of ovule. So this all is arising from the floral primordium of small papillate outgrowth of the this thing, that is carpal. From the carpal only it is arranged. In that we are seeing, I am explaining about the ovule. Okay, so here the ovule in the ovary, which is attached only by the placenta. So here our funicle, it's going, one end of the funicle is attached at the base of the ovule. Another end of the funicle is used to or help to attach the ovule to the placenta. So the funicle role is, it attached from the base of the ovule to, and it is going to attach the ovule to the placenta of the ovary. Okay, this is about the funicle. If you see the funicle, which is open at the place where the body of the ovule, so this is a yellow color, full yellow with the blue color is body of the ovule, which is covered by integument layer. And where the funicle, which is open into the body of the ovule, that place is called hilum. So this place is called hilum. Where the funicle is open into the body of the ovule is called hilum. Okay, next I am coming to the part which is the nucellus. So this blue color things, you can see some small cells. That cells is called parenchymatous tissue or the parenchyma cells. So parenchymatous tissues that making the body of the ovule. Body of the ovule, we should not say body of the ovule, we should say that is nucellus. The body of the ovule or the nucellus which is formed by the parenchymatous tissue. Okay, what is this called? Parenchymatous tissue. And as I already said that the integument layer which is made up of the body of the ovule which is covered by the integument layer. Based on the integumental layer, it is are two types are there. One is unitechmic and bitechmic. What is unitechmic and bitechmic means? Unitechmic means that is if the ovule is covered by one single layer, that is called unitechmic. If the ovule is covered by the two layers, is called bitechmic. So this is called unitechmic and bitechmic. But this unitechmic, that is this integument layer, fully covered the ovule, but except one place it leaves us. So what is that particular place is called? Micropyle. So this is place is called micropyle, where the integument layer is absent or it does not present it there. So that place is called micropyle. And if you see some, there is a some sac like area is present in below the micropyle end is called embryo sac. So there is some sac like area present inside the parenchymatous tissue or the nucellus is called the embryo sac or the female gametophyte. This is our female gametophyte or the embryo sac. Okay, so this is will be there. So in some plants, in some species you see the only one integument layer will be there. In some plants of the ovule having only one integument layer, that only one integument layer will be used to it is doing the nutritive function to the female gametophyte or the embryo sac. So this embryo sac or the nucellus will be this embryo sac or the female gametophyte nutrited by the single layer which is present in some species, example Asteraceae. So that one integument layer is called integumental tapetum or the endothelium. So that name is called endothelium or the integumental tapetum. So this is only I said ovule is also called megasporangium. It is covered by integument. The stalk or the funiculus, which is called the funicle, it's also called funicle. And hilum is junction between the ovule and funicle is called hilum. In an inverted ovule, if you see, there is the connection between or junction between the ovule and funicle is called hilum. The funicle, which is attached to the body of the ovule, it is forming a ridge-like structure is called raphe. So it is always attached to the base of the ovule. So it is somewhat look like ridge. So that it is called as a raphe. You see that this is called a raphe. By attaching of this funicle, it's making a some impression or the ridge like structure on the ovule of the body is called raphe. This red color is a blood supply, sorry, the vascular supply. Vascular supply means some water, some other nutrients will be going to like this one, like through this one. Okay. Integument micropyle, except at the pore is called micropyle. Unitechmic bitechmic ovule I explained you. Chalza, what is called chalza? So this place you see this integument layer, this nucellus of the body and this funicle all are attached to here. This place is called chalza lint. What is chalza lint? This integument layer, this nucellus of the body. Nucellus means body of the ovule is made up of parenchymatous tissue. So its name term is called nucellus. So this nucellus and the integument and the funiculus are collectively present at the region is basal region is called chalza lint. Okay, these are all presenting in the basal region is called chalza lint. Okay, next I am coming to the female gametophyte. And where is the female gametophyte? This female gametophyte always produced from the functional megaspore of the nucellus. What is functional megaspore of the nucellus? That I will explain you in the next video. So unitechmic tenonucellate, I already explained you what is the endothelium or the integumentary tapetum. In one integumentary tapetum in only one layer of the tapetum, in only one layer of the integumentary is there, integument layer is there in some ovules, example Asteraceae family. In that cases, that integument is used to nutrate the and our new cellular tissue and embryo sac, growing embryo sac. So that is called as endothelium or the our integumentary tapetum. Okay, next, types of the ovule. So before that, I'll explain you what is a unitechmic, what is a tenue nucellate. Tenue nucellate and a crassi nucellate, two types is there. Tenue nucellate means, that is you'll be see here, the types of the ovule is based on two types of ovules is there. One type, first type is the ovule is based on the sporogenous cells of the position. The another type is based on their orientation, form and position. So if you see in the type 1 of the ovule, based on the sporogenous cell position, based on the position of sporogenous cells is present with the hypodermal layer with single layer. Single layer of hypodermal cells is making a nucellate type is called tenue nucellate type. That is look like small nucellus. If you take a ovule with sub hypodermal sporogenous cells, will making a crassi nucellate. So nothing difference here. The sporogenous cell or the sporogenous tissue that is making with hypodermal single layer is forming a tenue nucellate. The same sporogenous cell or the tissue is made up of subhypodermal cell layer is making a crassi nucellate. The thing is that tenue nucellate type is small nucellus, that is parenchymata cells will be less here. But if you see this crassi nucellate, it is fairly large when compared to the tenue nucellate. So tenue nucellate means it is somewhat a bigger nucellate that is made up of hypodermal cells with the single layer. And crassi nucellate means that is made up of subhypodermal sporogenous cells, which is comparatively larger nucellus when compared to the tenue nucellate. What is hypostasis and epistasis? If you take your same diagram, your textbook diagram, this is here some group of cells is there. So here some group of cells in between the chalza and embryo sac is called the hypostasis. And there is a thick walled cells which is presenting at the top or the above the embryo sac and above the micropylar end is called the epistasis. So the meaning is there is in the group of cells in between the embryo sac and chalza end is called hypostasis. There is in the thick walled cell presenting the above the embryo sac and above the micropylar end is called the epistasis. Okay, this is the type 1. This thing and hypostasis and epistasis is different. These are the type of the ovule. And next, second types of the ovule is by the second type of classification of ovule is classified by orientation, form and position of the orientation, form and position of the micropyle with the respect to the funicle and chalza. So based on the position of the chalza to the funicle, funicle to the micropyle, based on their position and based on their form, based on their orientation, it is classified into six main types. In the six main types, the four is a very main type. First four is very main. And these two are very, it is not common, but these four are common and important. First type is, I'll show you in this, the orthotropous. What is called orthotropous? Its name is orthotropous. Orthotropous means, if you see this diagram, in the orthotropous of the ovule, here the micropylar end as well as here chalza as well as here funicle, all are will be present in the same vertical line. They all are in the straight vertical line, so that it is called orthotropous. Example you see, example is Piperaceae Polygonaceae. So if you see in the anatropous is very common. Whatever the flower we are watching, whatever we are seeing, that all the flower common, our common flowers all anatropous type only. If you see in the anatropous ovule, all will be completely inverted. So if it is in the completely inverted, here the micropylar end, the funicle and the chalza, all are funicle as well as these micropylar end, all are close to each other, so that it is look like called anatropous. The example is dicots and monocots, I told you. And hemianotropous, if you're taking a hemianotropous, that is hemitropous. It is not a hemitropous. It is hemianotropous. It is a hemianotropous. It is not a hemitropous. It is a hemianotropous. If you see this, if you keeping the ovule in the transverse incondition at a right angle to the funicle. So what they telling in Tamil? எப்படி சொல்லுவாங்கன்னா ஒவியூல் வந்து நம்ம வந்து இஃப் வி ஆர் கீப்பிங் இன் த ட்ரான்ஸ்வர்ஸ் பொசிஷன், ஒரு ட்ரான்ஸ்வர்ஸாக வச்சோம், இப்படி வச்சோம், நேர் இப்படி வச்சோம் அப்படின்னா, குறுக்க வச்சோம் அப்படின்னா அதோட ஒவியூல் அதோட ஃபனிக்கல் எப்படி இருக்கும் அப்படின்னா அதுக்கு ரைட் சைடில் இருக்கும். ஸோ த இஃப் வி ஆர் கீப்பிங் தி ஒவியூல் இன் த ட்ரான்ஸ்வர்ஸ் கண்டிஷன் அண்ட் அட் ரைட் ஆங்கிள் டு தி ஃபனிக்கல். ஸோ ரைட் ஆங்கிளுக்கு இருக்குது அப்படின்னு சொல்கிறாங்க. ஓகே, தட் இஸ் ஹெமியானோட்ரோபஸ் அப்படின்னு சொல்கிறாங்க. நெக்ஸ்ட் டைப் செமின கேம்பைலோட்ரோபஸ். ஹியர் த மைக்ரோபைல் எண்டு சம் வாட் இட் இஸ் லைட்டர். ஸோ சம் வாட் இட் இஸ் லைட்லி கர்வ்டு. அலாங் வித் த மைக்ரோபைலர் எண்ட் தேர் இஸ் அந்த கர்வ் இன் தி ஹைலம் அண்ட் ஃபனிக்கல். ஸோ இட் இஸ் லைட்லி கர்வ்டு, மோரலஸ் இட் இஸ் லுக் லைக் அ பீன் ஷேப்டு. ஸோ தேர் இஸ் அந்த மைக்ரோபைலர் எண்ட் அண்ட் த ஹைலம் அண்ட் த ஃபனிக்கல் ஆல் ஆர் க்ளோஸ் டு ஒன் அனதர். ஸோ தட் இட் இஸ் கால்டு தி கேம்பைலோட்ரோபஸ். எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் த கேம்பைலோட்ரோபஸ் அவர் லெகிமினேசிய ஃபேமிலி பிளான்ஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஐ எம் கம்மிங் டு த ஆம்பிட்ரோபஸ். ஆம்பிட்ரோபஸ் மீன்ஸ் இஃப் யூ சி ஹியர் திஸ் ஹைலம் ஆஸ் வெல் ஆஸ் திஸ் ஃபனிக்கல் ஹேவிங் எ வெரி லெஸ் டிஸ்டன்ஸ். தெர் இஸ் அ வெரி லெஸ் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் தி ஹைலம் அண்ட் ஃபனிக்கல் இஸ் கால்டு தி ஹார் ஷூ ஷேப்டு. இட் இஸ் லுக் லைக் ஹார் ஷூ ஷேப்டு. வை? பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தெர் இஸ் அ ஸ்பேஸ், வெரி லெஸ் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் த ஹைலம் ஆஸ் வெல் ஆஸ் தி திஸ் ஃபனிக்கல் இஸ் கால்ட் ஹார் ஷூ ஷேப்டு, கால்டு ஆம்பிட்ரோபஸ். எக்ஸாம்பிள் அலிஸ்ட்ரேசியே. இஃப் யூ சி த சார்சினோட்ரோபஸ் ஃபேமிலி, sorry, sarcinotropus ovule, it is the funicle is very large and slender and it is circulating the whole ovule is called sarcinotropus. Why it is called sarcinotropus? The funiculus is very long and it is circulate the ovule is called sarcinotropus. Example of the sarcinotropus is cactaceae family, that is cactus, opuntia, all those things will come here. Okay, so this is a all will be in the straight vertical line orthotropous, all completely inverted so that the panicle, micropylar end, all those things close to each other anotropous. Example is that is our monocot dicot, common monocot dicot. Next campylotropous, if you see the micropylar end slightly curved, more or less look like a bean shaped. So the micropylar end along with that hilum, panicle, everything is close to another, it is called campylotropous. Okay, next example is Primulaceae. This is Polygonaceae and Primaceae. Sorry, Polygonaceae and Piperaceae. If you're taking hemianotropes, that is, it is somewhat in the tail. Okay. If you are keeping in the transverse position, and it is a right angle to the funicle is called hemianotropes. Ambitropes, there is a loss of less distance between the hilum as well as the funicle is called the ambitropes. And sarcinotropes, the funicle is very long, so it is circulating our ovule is called sarcinotropes. Example cactaceae. So this is the original picture of the ovule. In the last year we did the dissection, but you may forget that thing, so I am showing you again. This is a ovule. The small beads is called ovules and these are all the stamens, filament and anther. This is androecium, this is a gynoecium. This part is called ovary and it consists of ovule. The same, this is a picture. This is a picturized picture and this picture shows the diagrammatic impression. This small beads is ovule and this big part is called ovary and this is your diagrammatic representation. This is your under microscope, this is your observation. So this is a complete your ovary. This is your ovary, elongated part is called ovary and it consisting of ovule and it is innervated with the placenta. This part is placenta and this is a full part of ovule just now we saw. This is a pollen tube. In the last video I had explained you the pollen is the full intine layer is coming out with the two male gametopods, other two sperms which is coming and fertilizing all those things. This is ovary, ovule, polar nuclei and pollen grains, everything. So this is a flower and cut section of the flower showing you. This is stigma, style, ovary consisting of ovules, all those things. So if you're taking the ovules, this is a pollen grain. And this is the next video I'm going to take about this one. This is a pollination. Pollination is fertilization. That is male and female gametes is fusion. That is, I had explained you what is the development of male gametophyte. and development of female hematopoiet. Okay, I hope you understand this video. Thank you all.